Hi, welcome back. My name is Chandrappa S., lecturer in Mechanical Engineering Program, Government Polytechnic, KGF. Today, I am going to teach a problems on cotter joint, that is solutions for the cotter joint problems. So, this is the last session or session number 14 in unit number 4, that is design of simple machine parts in machine design course of Mechanical Engineering Program. So, in this session, we are going to solve a different problem and this is the last session of this chapter. Then come to what is the chapter outcomes present in this. Number 1, design of machine elements like solid muff coupling, flange coupling subjected to direct and twisting moments and knuckle joint, cotter joint subjected to direct stress and analyze the various modes of failure. This includes with numerical examples. Come to previous session. The review of previous session is problems on cotter joints and MCQ. Now, the contents present in this session, that is session number 14, is problems on cotter joint continued and test. Then come to problem. So, the problem is third one. The two mild steel rods 40 mm diameter are to be connected by a cotter joint. The thickness of the cotter is 12 mm. Calculate the dimensions of the joint if the maximum permissible stresses are 46 MPa in tension, 35 MPa in shear and 70 MPa in crushing. Here the diameter of the cotter joint shaft is given and the thickness of the cotter is given. So, based upon the stresses values provided, so we have to calculate or design the cotter joint and we have to get the values of the different parameters of the cotter joint. Let's go for what is given. Diameter D 40 mm, thickness of the cotter that is 12 mm, sigma T that means permissible stresses in tension 46 MPa is about 46 Newton per millimeter square. Then tau is equal to 35 MPa that is shear stress 35 Newton per millimeter square and sigma C that is crushing stress that is 70 MPa in the number 70 Newton per millimeter square. Now come to the finding parameters are number 1 axial load of the joint, axial load of the joint that is P, then diameter of the spigot D1, diameter of the spigot collar D2, width of the cotter B, thickness of the spigot collar T1, diameter of the socket capital D1, diameter of the socket collar capital D, thickness of the socket collar L, distance from the end of the slot to the end of the rod that is L1 and thickness of the socket N is T2. So, these are the finding parameters from this problem. Now, come to first one, axial load of the joint. We know considering the tearing or resistance of the rod, the equation is 4.16a in page number 65, that is P is equal to pi d square by 4 into sigma t. Calculating capital P, the capital P value becomes 57.8048 into the power of 3 Newton. So, this is the axial load or axial thrust taken by the cotter joint. Now, come to second point, that is diameter of spigot. So, by the figure 4.4 in page number 66, the value of D1 is equal to 1.25 times of D. Then, applying the value of D, we will get the D1 is equal to 50 millimeter. Now, consider crushing, since the diameter of this spigot is going failure under crushing, the consider crushing, we will get the equation number 4.16b in page number 65. By applying the values, we will get the cap small d1 is equal to 68.81 millimeter. And also, the diameter of this spigot will go under tension, that means failure under tension. Considering the tension, the equation number 4.16c and page number 65 are by data handbook. By applying the values, we will get d1 is equal to 48.36. So, comparing the previous two values and this value, considering the maximum value these three values and from the table 3.5a in page number 57, the maximum value of this shaft, I mean diameter of the spigot will be 71 millimeter. That means, previously you got 50 millimeter, 68.81 and 48.36, 68.81 millimeter is the maximum, but from the standard, by considering the table 3.5a in page number 57, we can add up 71 millimeter. This is the diameter of the spigot. Then come to third point, that is diameter of the spigot collar, that is D2. D2 is equal to 1.5D as per the figure 4.4 mentioned in the page number 56, and calculated value is, by using this, is 60 millimeter. And also the spigot collar failure under crushing, then considering crushing, we will go for the equation number 4.16D in page number 65. Applying the values, we can find out the value of D2, that is D2 is equal to 78.05 millimeter. Considering the maximum these two value, that is 78.05, and from the table 3.5a, this is page number 57, the standard value of the D2, that is the diameter of the spigot collar, can be adopted as 80 millimeter. Then come to fourth point, width of the quarter. The width of the quarter is given by B, that is 1.25 times of D1. B is equal to 1.25 into 71 means the value of B becomes 88.75 millimeter. Then fifth point, thickness of the spigot collar. The thickness of spigot collar is nothing but T1, is a 0.5 times of D1 from the figure 4.4 in data handbook. Then the value is 35.5 millimeter. But the thickness of the spigot collar failure under shear, then consider the shearing, the equation number 4.16e in page number 65, then the calculated value of T1 becomes 7.4 millimeter. Considering the maximum these two value, the T1, the thickness of the spigot collar adapted, is 35.50 millimeter. Then come to sixth, diameter of the socket, that is capital D1. The capital D1 from the figure 4.4 page number 66 is 1.75 times of D. By applying the values, we will get capital D1 is equal to 70 millimeter. But this diameter of the socket failure under tearing. Considering tearing, there is equation number 4.17a page number 67. Then applying the values, we will get the quadratic equation of the different coefficients like this. So by using the quadratic equation, find out the roots of quadratic equation. Same formula can be applied here, but here we have to calculate the capital D1. By applying the quadratic equation method, calculating the D1 value becomes 82.58 millimeter. Considering the maximum of these two values, the maximum value is 82.58 millimeter, and I am rounding up it into 85 millimeter. That is, capital D1 is taken as 85 millimeter. Then come to 7th point, that is diameter of the socket collar. The diameter of socket collar is nothing but capital D. The capital D is equal to 2 times of small D1 from the figure 4.4 page number 66, and applying the values, we will get the diameter of capital D is equal to 142 millimeter. But this diameter will failure under crushing. Considering crushing, from the equation number 4.17b in page number 67, the values can be applied here and get the value of capital D. The capital D will become 139.81 millimeter. Considering the maximum of these two values, the capital D value must be 142 millimeter. There is the diameter of the socket collar is 142 millimeter. Then come to 8th point, thickness of the socket collar, that is L. L is equal to 0.75D as per the figure 4.4 in page number 66. Applying the values, we will get L is equal to 30 millimeter. But this L, that is thickness of the socket collar, failure under shearing. Considering shearing, P is equal to, that means equation number 4.17C in page number 67. And applying the values, we will get L is equal to 11.63 millimeter. Considering the maximum of these two values, we will get L is equal to 30 millimeter. Then come to point number 9. There is distance from the end of the slot to the end of the rod. So this is nothing but the L1. This is also 0.75 times of D as per the equation for figure number 4.4 in page number 66. And also applying the values, we will get L1 is equal to 30 millimeter. But this distance will failure under shearing. Then considering shearing, by using the equation number 4.16g, page number 65. So applying the values, we will get the L1 is equal to 11.63 millimeter. So considering the largest of these two values, L1 is equal to 30 mm can be adopted. Then come to last point, thickness of the socket end. So from the figure 4.4, the T2 value will be 0.5 times of D, and applying the values, we will get 20 mm. And also this thickness failures under shearing. Considering shearing from the equation number 4.17E from the phase number 65, then applying the values, getting the value of T2 is equal to 13.14 mm. Considering the maximum of these two values, the T2 value should be 20 mm can be adopted. So these are the values we will get from the above form for the result of the given problem. So this is the method to solve or to design a different values of the or different parameters of the quarter joint in this regard. And now come to last problem. There is a fourth problem of the quarter joint. Design a quarter joint to support a load varying from 30 kN in compression to 30 kN in tension. So in the compression also 30 kN they provided, 30 kN in tension also they provided. The material used for is carbon steel, for which the following allowable stresses may be used. The load is applied statically. The tensile stress is equal to compressive stress is equal to 50 MPa. That is, all tensile also is equal to 50 MPa. Compressive stress also is equal to 50 MPa. Shear stress is equal to 35 MPa and crushing stress is given 90 MPa. First of all, write down what is the given parameters. P is equal to 30 kN, 30 into 10 power 3 Newton. Sigma T is equal to 50 Newton per millimeter square. Tau is equal to 35 Newton per millimeter square. Sigma C crushing is nothing but 90 Newton per millimeter square. The finding parameters, what you have to find out? First thing, the diameter of the shaft. Second thing, the diameter of the spigot, that is D1. Third one, diameter of the spigot collar, D2. Diameter, the thickness of the quarter, that is T. Then width of the quarter, B. Thickness of the spigot collar, T1. Diameter of the socket, capital D1. Diameter of the socket collar, that is capital D. Thickness of the socket collar, L. Distance from the end of the slot to the end of the rod is, that is L1. And finally, thickness of the socket N, that is T2. So these are the finding parameters from the above said problem. Come to the point number 1, diameter of the shaft. So tearing resistance of the shaft or the rod is given by equation number 4.16A from page number 65. Applying the values, getting the diameter of the shaft, it is became around 27.63 mm from the standard table, that is 3.5A from the page number 57, the standard diameter of the shaft can be adopted as 28 mm. Considering this, go to second point, that is the diameter of the spigot. So this diameter of the spigot, that is D1 is equal to 1.25 times of D from the figure 4.4 in page number 66. And applying the values, we will get the value 35 mm. But this is the diameter of the spigot failure under crushing. Then considering crushing, the equation number 4.16B from the page number 65, then applying the values and finding out the D1, then we will get the D1 value should be 36.51. So by using figure, we got 35. And here we got 36.51. And also this files under tension, considering equation number 4.16C from the page number 65 and calculating the value of D by applying the thickness, then we will get the D1 value must be 33.47 millimeter. Considering the maximum value of all these three and from the standard timetable, diameter of the table, that is the 3.5A from the page number 57, the value of the D1 can be adopted is 40 mm. Then come to third point, that is diameter of the spigot collar. From the figure 4.4, we will get D2 is equal to 1.5 times of D. Applying the values, the T2 value became 42 mm. Also, this diameter of spigot collar falls under crushing. Considering crushing, for this, from the formula or equation number 4.16D in the page number 65, the value of D2 becomes 44.99 millimeter. And taking the maximum these two values, 44.99 is the maximum value, and from the table 3.5a and page number 57, the standard diameter value should be taken as 45 millimeter. Now come to point number 4, that is thickness of the cutter. The thickness of the cutter given by figure 4.4 page number 66 is 0.25 times of D1, calculated value is 10 millimeter. Now width of the cutter. The width of the cutter B is equal to 1.25 times of the D1 from the figure 4.4 page number 66, then calculated value B is equal to 50 millimeter. Then come to thickness of the spy guard collar, that is T1 is equal to 0.5 times of D1, then that is the figure 4.4 from the page number 66. Now the T1 value becomes 20 millimeter, but this thickness undergo and files under shear. So for considering the shear, there is the equation number 4.16e from page number 65. Applied the values, then we will get the T1 value must be 6.82. But considering both the values of this, we will get the maximum value of 20 millimeter. That is T1 is equal to 20 millimeter. Then come to point number 7, diameter of the socket, that is capital D1. It is 1.75 times of D from the figure 4.4 in page number 66, and the calculated value is 49 millimeter. Okay, but also this diameter of the socket undergoes tearing, that means failures under tearing. The considering shearing from the equation number 4.17a, page number 67, apply the unknown known parameters, and we will get the different equation here, and finally we will get the quadratic equation as like this. So by applying the quadratic equation method, finding out the roots of quadratic equation, same method can be applied here also to calculate the capital D1 value, and that means by using the quadratic equation, we will get the D1 value must be 49.9 millimeter. Considering the maximum of these two values, you adopt D1 is equal to 50 millimeter by rounding up the 49.90 millimeter. Then come to point number 8. What is it, point number 8? Diameter of the socket collar, that is capital D. Capital D is equal to 2 times of D1 from the figure 4.4, page number 66, and applying the value capital D is equal to 80 millimeter. But this diameter of the socket collar files under crushing. Then considering crushing from the equation number 4.17b in the page number 67, applying the values, then calculated value capital D is 73.33 millimeter. So considering the maximum by these two, capital D is equal to 80 mm can be adopted. Then come to point number 9, thickness of the socket collar, that is L is equal to 0.75 times of D as mentioned in the figure 4.4 in the page number 66. So applying the values, we will get L is equal to 21 millimeter, and this files under shearing stress and shearing strength. Considering shearing, by applying the equation number 4.17c from the page number 67 in data handbook, apply the values, and we will get the L is equal to 10.71 millimeter. Considering the maximum of these two, the L must be equal to 21 millimeter. Now 10th point. Distance from the end of the slot to the end of the rod, that is L1, is equal to 0.75 times of D from the figure 4.4 page number 66. Applying the values, you will get L1 is equal to 21 millimeter. But this will files under shearing. Considering shearing from the equation number 4.16g from the page number 65, applying the values, you will get L1 is equal to 10.71 millimeter. So considering the maximum value of these two, so L1 is equal to 21 millimeter can be adopted. Now come to last point, that is thickness of the socket end, that is T2 is equal to 0.5 times of D from the figure 4.4 in the page number 66. Applying the values, we will get T2 is equal to 14 millimeter. But this thickness files under shearing. Considering shearing from the equation number 4.17e in page number 65, so applying the values, we will get T2 value is equal to 9.74 millimeter. And also we will get the maximum value of these two, that is T2 is equal to 14 millimeter. Okay. So this is the end of this problem. Dear students, From the last session, that is session number 13 and session number 14, so in these two sessions, I solved around 4 problems. The method of solving the these problems are same from example number 1 to 4. While observing these two, I already explained in session number 13 that by observing the figure 4.4 from the page number 66, some standard values are given. That means L1 is equal to 0.75D, T2 is equal to 0.5D. That means calculated value of the diameter of the shaft, then we are finding out the different parameters. From last 4 problems, it has been observed that all the values which were calculated by using the equations present in the figure 4.4 are the higher than the calculated values considering the stresses. That means there is no need to consider stresses when we are using the equations from the figure 4.4 from the page number 66. But in the problem, they are given the allowable stresses. Then we have to consider equations also. That means we have to calculate by considering both figure 4.4 equations and also equations under a different equations to get the different values. Then we will conclude whichever is the maximum. So this is the procedure. You simply should not write by using the figure 4.4 equations, and this is not a way to solve the problems, because they were provided the stresses. We had to calculate from the stresses also. Then we have to calculate the based upon the equations present in the figure 4.4. Then we will conclude the maximum values of calculated or considered values of the quarter joint. Okay, come to multiple choice questions. So question number 1. Stress induced on contact area between the quarter and socket collar. Observe here, quarter and socket collar. Okay, shear stresses, crushing stresses, tensile stresses, and none of the above. So I told between quarter and socket collar. Here, what will happen? Crushing stresses will be induced. So then the answer is option B, crushing stresses. Question number 2. Taper on the quarter and slot is provide. Observe here, taper on the quarter and slot is provide. One side only, on both the sides, none of the side, none of the above. Actually, the one side only is the answer, that is option A. One side only is maximum, but in different condition they will go for both sides, but it is rare. So that's why we consider only one side only. So option A is the correct answer. Then come to question number 3. Quarter joint is a temporary fastening. True? False? Yes, it can be easily assembled and easily disassembled. Then it is nothing but a temporary fastening. The option is A, true. Then question number 4. The taper in the quarter varies from, that means taper of the quarter varies from 1 in 15 to 1 in 10, 1 in 24 to 1 in 20, 1 in 48 to 1 in 28, and 1 in 32 to 1 in 24. The actual answer is option C, 1 in 48 to 1 in 28. Then the key answers is like this, VAAC for 1B, 2A, 3A and 4C. And this is the end of session 14 and also end of the chapter or unit number 4. And this is our team of LMS for machine design for all the chapters. Thank you for listening this session and end of this chapter also, and this is number 4. Thank you very much and best of luck for everyone. Okay, bye.